Have you ever had to endure something uncomfortable, but knowing what is on the other end of it made it easier to endure? I remember the summer I graduated college, I worked two jobs that whole summer, two full-time jobs. I worked all night, and then I went to work during the day, and I was wore out. But I knew what was coming at the end of that summer. That was the summer that me and Shauna was going to get married.
Yeah.
So at I knew whenever July 28th come around that the two jobs would stop, and we would be able to get married. And that made it more or better to endure, I guess, easier to endure, knowing I had something so great to look forward to.
I was the reward.
A good one, too.
Hi, I'm Shauna, and this is my husband, Pete. And we are Gollihue Family Discipleship. We just ask you to come into our home and study the Bible with us. We're ordained ministers, and we have a passion for discipleship. This is how we disciple our family, through reading of the Word, discussing it, going through a chapter every week. And we are just asking you to study with us. So we are continuing our study with Romans chapter 8. And we're on verses 18 through 25. I'm actually going to read 18 and 19 and then 24 and 25. So follow along and then we'll get started with the discussion. It says, I consider that our present suffering are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed in us. For the creation waits in eager expectation for the children of God to be revealed. 24 says, for in this hope we are saved, but hope that is seen is no hope at all. Who hopes for what they already have? But if we hope for what we do not yet have, we wait for it patiently.
So what the Apostle Paul basically tells the Church of Rome here, what you're going through right now, is it pales in comparison to what God has planned for you. It may seem rough right now. It may seem like things are not going your way. But your reward is not right now. Your reward is eternity. And God has something planned for you, right? That first scripture she read in verse 18, I consider that your present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory of that God has revealed in us.
You know, Paul uses an example of birth pains later on, and he talks about those things. And here we sit, and we have went through 9 months of waiting on our little girl. And it's been a good pregnancy, but it's not been the easiest pregnancy. And there's things that we've had to endure, especially me, but things that I've had to change about my life, or medicine that I've had to take, or time that I had to spend in the hospital, whatever it may be. And you do it because you know that you are going to receive a reward of a child at the end. That's why so many women just totally forget the pains of labor, is because of that reward that's received.
So you may be going something through your life right now, and you might be thinking, man, this is rough, this is unbearable. You know, it might be sickness, could be pain, could be suffering, mental anguish, you know, all these things that we endure while here upon this earth. Just remember those things are temporary. And heaven awaits.
Mm-hmm.
There is a reward. You know, if you know any older individuals that we would call the older saints of God, those individuals look forward to their reward.
Yeah.
And whenever they start to get up in age, they start to say things like, I can't wait to go home. And they're not talking about to their earthly house. They're talking about to be in the presence of the Lord forever. And they've longed for it, and they've desired it, and their whole life they've looked forward to that moment to where they're going to see Jesus, and they're going to be in His presence. And that's what we need to understand, that what we're going through right now will pass away. We live in a broken world. It's broken from the top down to the bottom. Sin has destroyed this earth. What we see now is nothing what God meant it to be. Our pastor mentioned the other day during our Wednesday night Bible study, he said, you know what? In the world God created, there was no need for doctors. There was no need for nurses. There was no need for lawyers, policemen. All those things come about because of our sin.
Mm-hmm.
We live in a fallen world. It is a very, very corrupt creation.
Mm-hmm. That's right. You know, and I believe the worse that it gets, the more anxious everything is within society, within our world. We think about heaven more. You know, those songs about heaven. Mm-hmm. You know, that thought. You know, and even the prayer of, come quickly, Lord Jesus. You know, that desire, and we hope for the thing that we have not seen.
Right.
We hope for that. We hope for the glory of God to be revealed. We hope for the eternal paradise, the eternal peace.
So what we want to do right now is we want to encourage you. If you know Jesus Christ, it's getting better.
Yes.
If you don't know Jesus, it's not going to get any better.
Nope.
We want you to come to know Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You can make that decision now.
Absolutely.
You can make Him the Lord of your life, and you can also have that comfort in knowing that things are only going to get better.
Mm-hmm.
So going forward this week, we want to encourage you. There's four things that a disciple will do. We want you to encounter God every day. We want you to exalt God every day. We want you to edify yourself by reading the Word of God every day. And we want you to engage this world for Jesus Christ.
That's right. So until next time, may God bless you.